Hello everyone. In this video, I'm going to explain about item analysis in outcome-based education. In this, the first parameter is facilitation value. Facilitation value indicates the easiness of the question. That means in the question paper, a particular question is answered by all the students means facilitation value will become 1. No one has answered a particular question means facilitation value of that question is 0. 50% of the strength answered a particular question means facilitation value is 0.5. Here, we have to divide the entire class into 3 groups. The upper group size and lower group size as n, that is called group size. Group size equal to 30% of the total class strength. 30% we have obtained from Gaussian distribution. Marks allocated to each question will indicate with MQ. Sigma RU means sum of marks for correct answers in the upper group. Sigma RL is sum of marks for correct answers in the lower group. Then facilitation value is equal to sigma RU plus sigma RL divided by 2n into MQ. This is the equation to find out the facilitation value. The next parameter is discrimination index. Discrimination index is used to indicate how good is the question to separate the top scorers from the bottom scorers. That means the quality of the question we can identify here, how good the question is. Here the parameters is all the sigma RU, sigma RL, N, all these are just like the facilitation value. Only the formula changes like this. Discrimination index DI equal to sigma RU minus sigma RL by N into MQ. The next parameter which we are going to study is effectiveness of distractors. In the multiple choice questions, the correct answer is supposed A, but option C is just similar to the correct answer and it is distracting the students means that is called as distractor. So in this, what we'll do is how many students in the upper group are writing the distractor as the correct answer, that is RU. The number of students selecting the distractor as the correct answer in the lower group, that is RL. N is the group size, and ED, effectiveness of distractor, is RL minus RU by N. To understand all these concepts, we will solve some problems. First problem is something like this. Find the facilitation value for item 1. So this is the question paper, contains 5 questions. These are the marks obtained by 10 students. And all the marks are sorted in the descending order from top scorer to least scorer. Facilitation value is equal to sigma RU plus sigma RL by 2n MQ. So we have to find the group size. Group size is 30% of the total class strength. Class strength is 10. That's why 30% of 10 is 3. So top 3 scorers belongs to upper group. Bottom 3 scorers belongs to lower group. Then sum of the marks in the upper group students, sigma RU is equal to sum of these 3, that is equal to 29. Then sum of the marks of the lower group students, that is equal to sum of these 3, that is 24. Then marks allocated to this particular question is 10, that is indicated here, MQ equal to 10. Now facilitation value FV equal to sigma RU, that is 29, plus sigma RL, that is 24, by 2n, n equal to 3 into MQ equal to 10. Then that value we are getting something like this. This is the procedure to find out the facilitation value. Next, find discrimination index for item 1, DI value. DI equal to sigma RU minus sigma RL by n into MQ. First we have to find the n value. Group size n equal to 30% of the total strength, that is total strength is 10, 10 into 0.33. Next, sigma RU value is just like the previous problem, 29. Sigma RL value, sum of these 3, 24. And marks allocated to this is 10 only. Then if you substitute all these in this DI equation, it will be like this. DI value 0.167 we are getting. Next problem, find the FE value for item 1. This is multiple choice based question paper. Here the ranks of 15 students are given here in the descending order. He is the top scorer, he is the least scorer. Next, the marks allocated to each question is 1 mark. Now first step is, for finding FE, we have to find the group size. Group size is equal to 15 into 0.3, that is equal to 5. This is 4.5 something we can get, we can round up that to 5. Next, sum of the marks in the upper group. So upper group means top 5 students, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So among these 5 students, how many of them are answered correct? Means correct answer is C. Correct answers are 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 marks in the upper group. The sum of the marks in the upper group students is 4. Next, sum of the marks in the lower group students, sigma RL equal to, correct answer is C. In the bottom group, correct answers are 1, 2, 3. Sigma RL equal to 3. Marks allocated to each question is 1. Then FE equal to sigma RU, that means 4 plus 3 by 2 into N equal to 5 and MQ equal to 1. Then you will get this value as 0.7. Next problem is, find DI for item 1. Here this is the item 1. DI equal to sigma RU minus sigma RL by N into MQ. So group size 15 into 0.35. Sum of the marks in the upper group, sigma RU equal to 4. Sigma RL equal to 3. Marks for each question 1. Then DI equal to sigma RU minus sigma RL by N into MQ, that is 0.2. Next, find the effectiveness of distractor A for item 1. So in item 1, correct answer is C. How the answer A is distracting the correct answer, that we have to find here. ED equal to RL, number of distractions in the lower group minus number of distractions in the upper group by total group size. Group size equal to 5. You can take top 5, bottom 5 like this. Number of distractors in the upper group is equal to, here in the upper group, number of distractions is only 1. A is indicated by only 1 student, that is RE equal to 1. Number of distractions in the lower group means, in the lower group, how many students answered A means 1, 2, 2 students, sigma RL equal to 2. That means RL equal to 2. ED equal to RL minus RU by N, that is equal to 0.2 we are getting. In this way, we can do the item analysis in outcome-based education system. Thanks for watching my video. If you like this video, please subscribe to my channel.